What's going on, everybody? Hey, so today I want to talk to you about a question that someone recently asked me about how to get over a breakup. So we have all been there before. The relationship that you are in, your marriage or relationship, is come to an end. What is the best thing that you can do to immediately start to feel a little bit of peace of mind about what's going on in your life? So the first thing that I suggest is, if you have not already found it, you need to start following and pursuing your purpose. That is the most important thing you can do to get over a relationship once it has come to an end. The reason that pursuing your purpose is so beneficial to you is because it gives your life meaning. When you are pursuing your purpose, that is all you should be focused on in your life. You shouldn't be focused on any other parts of your life except accomplishing the mission that you know deep inside was the reason that you were put here on this earth. So pursue your purpose. Do not stop pursuing your purpose, which is what a lot of people end up doing after a relationship ends, is just stop doing the thing that lights them up inside. So start pursuing your purpose if you haven't already, and continue to pursue your purpose if you already are pursuing your purpose. Now, the next thing you can do to get over a relationship or a breakup is start taking care of yourself, both physically and mentally. What does that mean? That means making sure that you are setting time aside each and every single day to do some sort of physical exercise. That can be anything from cardio or going to the gym, or, you know, doing something like just taking a run, going for a hike. But you need to make sure that you regularly incorporate exercise, physical exercise, into your daily routine, because that in and of itself is just going to make you feel better physically. And as you start feeling better physically, you'll start feeling better emotionally. All of these endorphins like dopamine and serotonin get released when you're exercising. So you want to make sure that you're taking good care of your physical health. The next thing that you should be doing is making sure that you're consuming a clean, alkaline-based diet with organic products. The fresher, the better. So if you consume a lot of processed foods, a lot of junk food, a lot of fast food, a lot of foods that just kind of bog you down, you really want to take notice to what you are fueling your body with. So starting to consume a diet that consists of 80% greens and then 20%, you know, maybe some sort of protein, lean protein, and foods that only have one ingredient, you guys. That's the best rule of thumb. If you guys are getting things with 20 different ingredients on the label, it's probably not the best quality food. There's probably a ton of preservatives in there. It's likely not fresh food. So make sure that you're consuming a very high quality diet. Now, the final thing that you should do to get over a recent breakup is start dating again, you guys. Put yourself out there. I know that it's going to feel uncomfortable when you start dating again after a relationship ends or a marriage ends. You're thinking it's weird because you've got a little bit of some mixed emotions. You want to embrace your life as a single individual, but you've still got some feelings that are tied up to your old relationship and with your old partner. So you really have to just put yourself out there. You have to start going out on dates. That doesn't mean you have to start, you know, getting involved in a serious relationship. I can tell you that when I got out of my marriage and I would meet somebody that I was interested in, I let them know from the very jump the position that I was in, and I set clear expectations so that I wasn't blindsiding them out of nowhere if they started to catch, you know, feelings faster than I did. So what I used to do is I would just let the people know that I was dating, that I was really just at a point in my life where I wanted to casually date. I was more than willing to see where things went, and I just wanted to let things progress naturally. You guys, there is nothing wrong with not being in a point of wanting a serious relationship and starting to date. That is the entire reason that you go out and you date. There are people who are looking for that very same thing. Why do you guys think relationships like the friends with benefits relationships exist? They exist because there's a lot of professionals who don't have time to invest in a serious relationship. So they still have sexual needs that they want to have met, but they don't want to have that daily obligation and responsibility to call, to check in, to set up dates, to, you know, be there for somebody else. So they would rather have a friends with benefits situations so that their physical needs are being met while they don't have to worry about all of the things that come along with being involved in an intimate relationship. So if you start putting yourself out there, eventually you are going to see that the world is a place of abundance. You are going to find somebody that meets and or possibly surpasses your frequency level, which means that you guys are riding on the same line. And those are the people that you are going to find the most compatibility with. So make sure that you don't cut off the idea of dating. Listen, if you need time to work on yourself, I absolutely support and admire that. And I certainly don't think that you should be going out and dating until you feel ready, because that is going to then put the other person in a position to where they might potentially get hurt, which we want to avoid doing. You're not going out there to intentionally, you know, hurt somebody or just find somebody to rebound with, but you're going to start, you're going out on dates to start helping yourself move on. And when you're feeling better physically because you are taking care of your body by exercising, and when you start feeling better emotionally and mentally by making sure that you are consuming high quality foods. And another thing you can do in addition to that is meditate. That is making sure that your mind stays in a peaceful and centered and balanced state. Then you should feel like you know when it's time to put yourself out there and start dating. So are you recently single and have maybe just ended a relationship or a marriage? I would love to hear from you. What has your experience been like, you guys? Are you struggling to find that inner peace and find that balance in your life? Let me know what your challenges have been. And if you guys have any questions for me, feel free to leave them below as well. But if you need my help personally, head on over to my website at thebalancedalpha.com and sign up for whatever coaching session works best for you. But until then, I look forward to seeing you guys next time. Be well.